It's September 18th. I'm going in for my evening hunt here. It's very humid. Not expecting a lot of deer movement this evening, but we do want to go ahead and bring you a new video today. We're flashing this video back a couple of years, hunting a particular deer that I encountered for the first time on that hunt, named Big D. He was a three-year-old in this hunt. We passed him up, and he really never blossomed to be a really, really big, massive deer, but he is a very... He'd be a trophy if we harvested him. He's a 6.5-year-old buck. This is my first encounter with him ever. And we also have a pretty crazy encounter with another big 8-pointer right under the tree. So we wanted to bring you that hunt today. If anything exciting happens on tonight's hunt, we'll check back with you on that as well. If you haven't already, we want you to subscribe to our YouTube page. We're going to be posting a lot of new hunts, flashbacks, and semi-live hunts from this season in 2021. So like I said, go ahead and subscribe, hit that notification bell so you're notified anytime that we post a new video. Most of our views are not from our subscribers, so it's really important you all do that. We want to hit our goal of 1,000. And again, we're going to go in this hunt this evening. We appreciate you guys watching, and we'll see you later. It's October 20th. It's the early muzzleloading opener here in Kentucky. We've got a couple of days to get it done with the smoke poles. This morning we're hunting in a stand, one of our favorite spots. We've been getting some pictures of some bucks, mainly nocturnal, but last weekend, same conditions. They were moving around, kind of rainy, wet conditions. We got about 51 degrees. Pretty gusty right now, blowing out of the northwest. It's hitting us right here in the side of the head. And going back up this creek back here behind us, so these deer. There's an oak ridge over behind the camera that I would suspect there's probably been some deer working on if there's many acorns. So we're kind of here in this pinch point. We're just going to sit tight. Matt and Derek are in the muddy bull blind across the field. We can see them. Hopefully one of us will see something. We've got some shooters hopefully we'll see this morning. Stay with us. 9:15 now. We're starting to get stuff together to get down the tree. Just not even a couple minutes ago, we had a bobcat chase a turkey off. The turkey flew up. That bobcat come out earlier right underneath us. Looked right up at us one time. It eased off in the corn. We heard the turkey butting over there. We thought it was that bobcat. Sure enough, it was.
There's bobcat again, Mike.
There is again.
See them. They should be able to see them.
Look, that one's running that other one.
That's crazy.
Look.
Dick's staring down the look down the road.
And that one's gone in the corn.
Still see it.
Yeah.
It's going down the edge.
It's pretty wild. wrap up number three. Try it again.
We're gonna try to get down. We may get attacked by a bobcat.
Now they're headed right towards them. You can see them down there. They're in the muddy blind right there. Dad and Derek over there. Bobcats are heading right to them. It's October 20th. We're on our evening sit here. We just got back into the stand. We got down, got some lunch, and went around, checked our scrapes, put some rack getter scents, Climax out in them, and checked the Muddy Pro cams. And a lot of, we've had several bucks on camera, a lot of activity just after dark. This morning I did have an encounter with a pretty good buck, about 22 yards, right behind the camera, but just things just didn't go as planned. Didn't know whether to shoot or not. He's a pretty good deer, but I know we've got some bigger deer, so holding out just a little bit longer. But if he comes back out, I might be tempted to shoot this time. So, got a really cold front, really big cold front. Moving in tonight, going to be in the 30s tomorrow. Hopefully, one of these deer will come in and check one of these scrapes that we doctored up. Wind's hitting us right in the face. It's going right back up in the holler, right where those deer actually came from this morning. A lot of times these deer like to come from this side over here. So it's pretty windy. We're going to get settled in here. Hopefully we'll see some deer. Well, guys, we just got back home. It's about 7:45 now, and had a pretty eventful day hunting today. We seen two shooters, passed one early this morning. Kind of had some regrets about not trying to take a shot on him, but this evening, as you saw, we had a bigger buck come right underneath us, a bigger 8-pointer that we call Andy, come right underneath us, and then Big D, the one we seen earlier this morning, also scourged us in the food plot, kind of bumping off some does off the food plot. So he came right underneath us, and we just ran out of shooting light. He had his back to us the whole time, and we couldn't really take an ethical shot and run out of light. Just wasn't the way we wanted to end the story on this buck. So we still got some good hunting ahead of us this year, so we're going to get back at it tomorrow morning. We got a really cold front coming in here shortly. You already feel it in the air. The wind's picking up, air's getting cool. So we're going to get back after it tomorrow, and hopefully we'll finally close the book on one of these bucks.